The interesting part for me is, you know, I started all by myself. And then almost immediately, within about 3 or 4 months of starting to write the scripts, I brought in Doug and a few of the other designers. And then we, you know, there's a little group, and then we started building that little group that's the design group from the attic. And we've worked for 2.5 years together. And what I've done is, you know, over those 2.5 years, spent huge amounts of time approving, changing, and finalizing designs for things. You know, thousands of things.
Fine art was very important, especially to the Queens people. And they really appreciated it. You can tell in their architecture, their sculpture, and their clothing, and so forth. And in episode one, that element naturally carries over to their hardware or their vehicles. I grew up on certain types of science fiction films. I was a big science fiction fanatic as a kid. But when I saw Star Wars, I was really blown away, but I was actually kind of like, there are certain things that I didn't like about it. But the great thing was I went home and I kind of drew, you know, my version of the X-Wing.
I'd make this cockpit about a quarter of the size that it is, and I'd stick it back here. And then I'd take the engine part and I'd sort of cut this part off right here.
I started with a staff of two, and we were given a huge list of vehicles, creatures, environments, and whatnot to design. And it was just a matter of sitting down and trying to comprehend, you know, where to start first, and then how to design something that will live up to the expectations of everybody that's going to see this film. George is very reactive, and he likes to kind of see things. And he basically just said, you know, I need single-person fighters and shuttles and so forth.
So just like a small shuttle type thing?
No, I don't know what it is. Don't ask me those technical questions. It's neat, that's all.
My decisions on what is aesthetically pleasing is really hard to nail down, because what I like is, you know, obviously going to be different from what somebody else likes. You know, it's a matter of getting in sync with George. And I hope that I've kind of gotten in sync with George on this film. For the Starfighter, the good guys, it started out very differently, because I initially thought that the ships would be very angular, like the X-Wing, but George wanted to go more towards the handcrafted look. George would come in every Friday for our weekly meetings, and it was very difficult sometimes because we spent a lot of time and energy to, you know, draw beautiful drawings, and we put them up on the wall, and George will dismiss these designs very quickly. And it took me a while to get used to it, because one of our first couple of meetings, I would put up a wall full of designs, and he would look at it literally after 10 seconds there, like this one, this one, this one. Episodes 4, 5, and 6 kind of had the industrial mentality in terms of spaceships were punched out. They were kind of like plastic materials. Things were kind of mass produced. It kind of happened with the industrial design in the United States. We had, you know, an era in the 20s and 30s where things were more romantic and the craftsmen were the king. But then slowly, as the Industrial Revolution took over, machinery and mass production became the norm. I'm not quite sure if this is George's take, but for me, when that pattern clicked, everything made sense in terms of designing for this film.
I was very clever in the first Star Wars films in that I kept the design very simple. And I avoided situations where I was going to get into trouble design-wise. This one, I'm daring to take the chance and see what happens.
I think about this constantly. I mean, it's going to the third year, and there hasn't been a day or an hour where I haven't thought of something that could work. On the Starfighter alone, we went through easily 3 dozen drawings.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
That's only one vehicle in a world populated by many vehicles, many creatures, everything. For weathering, to see if this is the right amount, too much, not enough, what your general reaction is.
I would say this is the most distressed.
Okay.
And then they can do minor, less versions of this.
Okay. Now the other thing that we haven't really addressed is like paint chips and things. Do you want to see that?
Keep it pretty much the way it is. I mean, the one thing that I would tone down a little bit is this.
Okay. It's gotten a little too dirty.
Yeah.
Okay. the whole point of this is what works for the story. It could be the coolest thing, but if people don't know what it is or how it works in 5 seconds, it doesn't matter.